Welcome to medical stuff. Today we'll study the norma basalis. The norma basalis outer part, inner part is foramina, holes, condines, protuberance. All we will study in this video. So do not skip the video. Also like, share, subscribe the channel. So first of all, you can see the norma basalis. This part, this arch is known as the alveolar arch. You can see my precursor moving on the alveolar arch in which there are teeth and teeth sockets. This whole part is known as the heart plate. This whole part is the heart plate. Now heart plate divided into two parts. Upper part, this part above this line, this part is known as the palatine, possessor maxilla, and below you can see this part is known as the palatine bone. So heart plate divided into palatine, possessor maxilla, and this is the palatine bone. Now you can see below the palatine bone, you can see two inputs, two holes going inward the foramina basalis. This where you can see my precursor. This two holes are known as conae, C-H-O-N-A-E, conae. So these two holes are conae. Now this bone is known as the zygomatic bone. Where you can see my precursor, this is the zygomatic bone, and at the backwards side, zygomatic bone attached with the temporal bone. This is known as the temporal bone. This bone and this bone is known as the syphenoid bone. Yevali bone or Yevali bone is known as the syphenoid bone, where we will study the foramina later on. Now this is the foramen magnum. In front of foramen magnum, there is a pharyngeal tubercle. So this is the pharyngeal tubercle. Now on sides of pharyngeal tubercle, you will see the occipital condyle. Now this and this part is known as occipital condyle. You see, because this is occipital condyle and this is occipital condyle. Now this process, you can see small process elevating upward. It is known as the stellate process. Now this process is known as stellate process, which will come in all speech important. Now on the occipital bone, you will see this part. This is known as external occipital crest. Below the foramen magnum, immediately there is external occipital crest, where you see my precursor. Now up totally backward to the norma basalis and the occipital bone, you can see this is known as the external occipital protuberance. So this is external occipital protuberance and this is the external occipital crest. Now this process and this process, now they are large processes. They are very important in OSPI and in VIVA. This is known as mastoid process. This is also known as mastoid process. It was about the bony parts. Now we will study about the foramina. Now we will study about the foramina of the norma basalis external part, which is important in VIVA and OSPI, and it is very important. Now first of all, you can see this foramina. This is known as the incisive foramina or incisive foramina. This is known as incisive foramina. You can see my precursor. This foramina upward, you can see this is greater palatine foramen. This foramina is known as greater palatine foramen. Here you can see my precursor, my arrow. This is known as lesser palatine foramina. So this where my precursor, you can see this is the lesser palatine foramina. Now you can see this process which are the part of the palatine bone. It is known as posterior nether spine. So this spine is known as posterior nether spine. Now you can see this bed shape bone emerging from the sides. You can see this bone and this bone is known as the pterygoid process. This is known as pterygoid process. Now this is known as occipital bone. If you see my arrow, this is occipital bone, and backward to occipital bone, this is pharyngeal tubercle. The foramen magnum, the largest foramen, very important. Now we can see the small foramina. First of all, beside the lateral to the occipital bone, this is the first foramina. You can see where my arrow is writing the L. This is known as foramen lacerum. So this is the foramen lacerum. Now side of the foramen lacerum, the upward most upward foramina, we can see my precursor and writing O. This is known as foramina ovale. So this is the foramina ovale. Below the foramina ovale, this where you writing S, and you can see my arrow, this is known as foramina spinosum. So foramen ovale, foramen spinosum. Now below the foramen spinosum, there's a little bit large foramina or a canal. We call it carotid canal. So this you can see my precursor and your arrow like this. This is the carotid canal. This is the carotid canal. Now you can see the foramina emerging inside the pharyngeal tubercle inside of side of the bone. This emerging inward, you can see arrow. This is hypoglossal canal. So this canal you can not see properly in this photo, but this is the hypoglossal canal. You can see emerging inward to the norma basalis. This is hypoglossal canal. Now this foramina below the carotid canal is jugular fossa. So this is the fossa, or the jugular fossa. We can see my arrow, jugular fossa. Below jugular fossa and the last foramina on the side of the norma basalis is known as stylomastoid foramen. This foramen is called stylomastoid foramen. This is jugular fossa and this is stylomastoid foramen. And these two tubercles, you can see occipital condyles, and that is foramen of the foramen magnum. So this was all about foramen of the external part. Thank you so much.